Well, good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to another one of these virtual reality organ concerts from Leeds Minster. Today I shall be playing just one piece, but a fairly substantial one, by Sir George Dyson. It's called the Fantasia and Ground Bass. A little potted history, perhaps, of George Dyson. He was born just up the road in Halifax in 1883, and he was the son of a blacksmith and a weaver. Both his parents were musical, they sang in choral societies and things, and the father was in fact himself a church organist and director of music. So perhaps it wasn't too surprising that by the age of 13, George had also acquired himself an organ console and was running the music at a little church somewhere in the locality. Well, by the age of 17, he went on to the Royal College of Music on a scholarship, and he was a pupil of composition with Sir Charles Villiers Stanford. And so that didn't do him any harm at all. The next development was in fact George's first official publication, but perhaps a rather surprising subject, because George by then was a grenadier in the Royal Fusiliers, and he had a fairly senior position there too. And he wrote a pamphlet on the subject of the art of grenades in warfare, and apparently it's still very much, although only a pamphlet, it's still a required textbook, if you like. So after the war he went into school teaching, and eventually he reached the top. He became the principal of the Royal College of Music, the first apparently alumnus so to do, and he was very proud of that. As principal, he thoroughly overhauled the financial structure of the college to make it be able to get through the Second World War, and he was there until he retired in about 1952, and then he moved to Winchester, where, according to one of his sons, he enjoyed an Indian summer of composition. And this piece that I'm going to play today, the Fantasia and Ground Bass, seems to date back to 1960, so very much towards the end of Dyson's life. And it's a great piece. The Fantasia begins with a very stern opening in the key of A minor. It gradually dissolves into a really good-humoured allegro before the introduction returns to sort of balance the composition out. Then the ground bass, which unusually only lasts for 10 bars rather than perhaps 8 or 16. It's in the usual triple time, minim crotchet, that sort of idea, and it's in the tonic major, it's in A major. I haven't counted the number of variations, but I think there are something of the order of 15, and the whole thing comes to a rather thunderous conclusion.